Wolf, and what we're learning is that on the city's website today, the police chief answered questions put to him by the city manager, questions that the city manager said were being commonly asked by the people. Amongst them, why wasn't George Zimmerman arrested? And the police chief responded that under Florida law, the officers were prevented from arresting Zimmerman because he claimed self-defense. Well, on what grounds did Zimmerman claim self-defense? Well, we're learning in this letter, in this report, this answer, this question and answer, the police chief wrote that, quote, Zimmerman's statement was that he lost sight of Trayvon and was returning to his truck to meet the police officer when he says he was attacked by Trayvon. Of course, that was after he placed the phone call to 911 that there was this young man in the neighborhood and that he was following Trayvon. Now, on his show Anderson, Anderson Cooper today spoke with two women who live in the neighborhood who witnessed what happened, and he also spoke with Trayvon's parents.
When you both went outside, you saw George Zimmerman in where, and where was Trayvon Martin?
She was out the door first. When I came out the door, I saw him basically straddling him. He had, feet on either side of his body, and his hands, at the time I didn't know, was on his back. And
Trayvon was face down.
Trayvon was face down. Once he got off of the body, we could see that his face was down in the grass. So at the time that he was holding his back, I didn't know if he was trying to help him hold the wound or he was. Selma had asked him several times, three times, what's going on? Is everything okay? And each time he looked back, but he didn't say anything until the third time he just said, just call the police.
The eyewitnesses have said they believe, some of them believe it was your son calling out for help. No one saw him directly doing it could say 100% for sure. You've heard the 911 call where you hear somebody calling out help. Do you believe that is your son's voice?
Yes, I do. I believe that's Trayvon Martin. That's my baby's voice. Every mother knows their child, and that's his voice.
And the fact that if that's true and he called out for help, what does that tell you?
He was afraid for his life. He saw his death coming. He saw his death coming. The screams got more franticer. And at that second that we heard the shot, the screams just completely stopped. He saw his death. He was pleading for his life.
So you're saying if it was Zimmerman who was screaming for help, that might have continued after the shot, but yeah. The fact that after the shot, there was no more scream for help.
No more screaming whatsoever. It went completely silent.
Now behind me here at City Hall, a special meeting going on at the City Council. They are discussing moving next week's regularly scheduled City Council meeting to the Convention Center, which seats 600 people, because they expect they will have a huge crowd there to hear what's being discussed, to hear what's happening, what the latest is, what's going to be done. And they think they need that larger venue because they expect, Wolf, all 600 seats will be filled.